Hey everybody, Lissy here. So God was just reminding me about forgiveness and how important that is in this season, as it is with every season, but especially now. I felt this word of remember what you've been forgiven of. And often there's two sides to this, because when we look at what we've been forgiven from and forgiven of, it brings out this gratitude in our hearts. Sometimes we can forget everything that God has forgiven us of. We can forget everything that God has every right to hold a grudge against us for. And yet he instantly forgives as soon as we ask for that forgiveness. And he throws it into the sea of forgetfulness, and he removes it. And God was just talking to me about that just now, about how important it is to be showing that same forgiveness to other people. And I felt like there's people who are going to watch this video that you know this, but God wants to remind you, because there's actually things in your heart that have been sitting there for a while, and there's little offenses, there's little things here and there that he wants to remind you, like, hey, don't forget, like, remember what you've been forgiven of. And in the same way, God tells us in the word that we need to forgive, because that if we expect to be forgiven, we need to forgive. And it's a two-way street, where God wants us to also then show that forgiveness. You see it in some of the parables as well, of just this principle that God wants us to echo what he's done in our lives. Another side to this word is that there's going to be healing to you as well. There's going to be a full total healing. Some of you thought you had healed, and then you found like a whole other cave within your heart and your soul that was broken and hurt by people in your life, and God wants to heal you of that too. And after you heal, God is going to bring restoration to many of you. You kind of think the situation is too far gone, but God actually wants to bring restoration. He just wants you to heal. He wants you to let the other person heal. He wants to restore after the healing has completed. So that's another side of the word too for some people. But make sure you pray and just ask God which part of this is for you. It could all be for you, but like, not everything's gonna apply to everyone. But yeah, just to remember the power of forgiveness. Remember what we've been forgiven of. And you know, the enemy works overtime to get us into offense, get us into unforgiveness, get us into bitterness, get us into messes relationally, messes spiritually, messes mentally and emotionally. Like, he wants us to be in constant chaos and turmoil, but Jesus is the Prince of Peace. And peace is the opposite of all of that. So if you find yourself just like on edge, take some time and sit with Jesus and just ask him, like, Jesus, what is, like, just, you know, that scripture, search me, know my anxious thoughts. See if there's anything in me that offends you, God, and lead me in the way that's everlasting. Let God reveal to you anything in your heart that needs to go. Aim to end this year with a heart with such purity and wholeness that you don't even recognize yourself. And I'm telling you, like, blessing follows your life when you forgive. When you let go, even if you have every right in the world to be mad and angry and hurt, and even, you know, I want to encourage you, if people have hurt you, cover them. Cover their name. You don't have to tell the whole world what happened. God knows, and you can just sit in that, knowing that he's faithful, and just give it to him. Let him fight your battles, and you just sit in his goodness and his love, and let him heal you. Let him heal you, and just sit there and let the Lord love on you in those places where you were mistreated. Let him love on you. And you know, not everyone may know your side of the story, and that's okay. You just trust God, and you just love God, love people, and trust God, and do everything in your power. You are responsible for your heart. You're going to stand before God. You're not going to tell him, well, this person. He's going to be directly focused on your heart, the condition and the state of your heart. So let's aim to end this year with, sorry, I haven't had my coffee yet. It's right here. I need to drink it because I'm waking up. But let's aim to end this year just like fully pure, clean, no wounds, just like ready to run. Because There's just too much going on right now to, we don't have time to be carrying different things in our lives that God doesn't want us to carry. The only thing He wants us to carry is adoration for Him, a love for Him, a love for people, a love to share the gospel. We're not created to carry offense and all these things, because that's actually, that can end up making us sick. That can end up sin. That is sin, and sin makes us sick. You look at people who have lived lifestyles of sin, and God can redeem. It's actually really cool. One of my favorite things to see, there's many things, but one of them is seeing how, for one, when people encounter the presence of God for the first time, I love that. The other thing is I love seeing where people like get radically transformed when they've lived a lifestyle and then they get set free, and to like see how their countenance changes. It's so cool when you walk in freedom and holiness and purity and you're whole inside. It's like you glow, you shine, and I feel like there's people who like are watching this as well, that you kind of feel like you look at yourself and you feel like you're kind of you don't feel like you're carrying that same spark. You feel like you've lost that. There might be people in your life who have hurt you and caused that light to dim. I want to encourage you, let that go. Forgive, you know. Maybe God will reconcile, you know, that relationship. Maybe God will reconcile that family member. Maybe God will reconcile that job, whatever it was, whatever the situation, like put it in God's hands and let Him be in control. Those things are too much for us to try to control. It's not for us to control. That's for God to control those things. That's for God to have that control and for Him to do what He wants to do. And ultimately, we want to be in the center of His will. Ultimately, we want to be right where He wants us to be. And that is the safest place. That's the happiest place. And we were made to live in peace and unity with the Lord, and holiness and love and joy and peace, like all the fruits of the Spirit. That's God's will for you, to be full of love and joy and peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. God, that's God's will for you. That's His will for you of how your day looks. And then if you take those fruits of the Spirit, 1 Corinthians 13, love is patient, love is kind. You know, you can even put God's name in there. God is patient, God is kind. All of the fruits of the Spirit. God says He is love in Scripture. There's a verse in the Bible. I wish I knew exactly which one, but it says that God is love. He literally describes Himself as love. So you look at 1 Corinthians 13, you look at that list, and that is God. If you ever wonder, is God good? Is He really good? Look at Scripture, because He tells you His nature. And so I want to encourage you guys, like, His will for you is not to be bitter and sad and it's hard. I know what that's like to like go through hard times, and it's a struggle. Sometimes it feels more comfortable to stay in that place than to come out of it and choose to rise up again. I want to encourage you to choose to rise up again. That's another part of this word that I was feeling, like, choose that. You have to choose. It's a choice. God says He sets before us life and death. Choose life, choose death. Choose today who you will serve. You know, there's so many points in the Scripture where it talks about choice and decision. I mean, the Garden of Eden, they chose to listen to the snake, to the devil, rather than to listen to what God had said, because they questioned His nature. So in this season where God is wanting to pull you out and you need to rise up, you need to choose today who you will serve. Are you going to serve your emotions? Are you going to serve your pain? Are you going to serve the Almighty Living God? Are you going to serve the God who was and is to come and loves you deeply? Are you going to choose to let Him fill your life with all those fruits of the Spirit, which comes from His Spirit dwelling within you? Choose today. Choose life. Choose Jesus. Choose His side. Choose freedom. Choose forgiveness. They say that when you don't forgive someone, it's like drinking the poison and hoping that the other person gets poisoned. But instead, you have been drinking the poison of unforgiveness. You've been drinking the poison of bitterness and, oh, they need to get what's coming to them and all this stuff. Like, that is not God's heart. And God is a God of justice. It says that He will fight for us, you know. And so just give it to God and just wish people well and just let that all go. It's too much for you. I see some of you like it's so much. It's so much. And I'm not at all canceling out the validity of your pain. I am not at all canceling that out. I want you to know that. But I want to encourage you today. God's saying, rise up, choose life. Choose life. He doesn't want you day after day to not want to live. He wants you to live life to the full. He wants you living in peace and joy. I'm feeling teary again because I feel his presence. He loves you deeply. He wants you free. He wants you free. He wants you free. He wants you free. So today, choose. What are you going to choose? Choose. Choose. You know, if you feel like you don't have the strength to choose, God, help me to choose. Help me to choose what you want me to choose. Help me to choose what you have for me. Help me to choose your way. Help me, God, to forgive. I love you guys. Have an amazing day. And just remember, rise up. Rise up. Rise up today. He wants you to rise up. He wants you to be free. He wants you to exude all those fruits of the Spirit. He wants you living abundant. He wants you whole and healthy, because that's how you're going to represent Jesus the most. Because Jesus is whole and healthy. God is not insecure. God is all powerful. He is holy. He is, his name literally shakes hell. Like, you can say his name and demons flee. It's incredible. Like, I've gotten to pray for people and see them delivered, and it is just like the power of God. It's just, it's incredible to see what we read happen. I want to encourage you, live a life like you're seeing in the scriptures, like you're reading in the scriptures. Our lives should not look much different to that. That's a blueprint of how God wants our lives to look. You know, are our lives looking more worldly than godly? What is it that God has called you to do? Just some things to ponder. I love you guys, and I will see you next time.